Well, hi, how are you?
Let me
ask you, let me ask you about this trip. Tell me a little bit about the history.
Well, this trip is a sort of recreation in reverse of a trip made by two young Mexicans in 1956 who rode their bikes up to Toronto and stayed in Canada and raised their families. And one of their daughters is a documentary filmmaker and made a film called Cyclist that recounted, told about the history of their trip and took them back over the trip to see the changes that had happened in Mexico and the United States and the changes that happened in their family as well. So it was a very, very well written documentary. And it inspired me to do the trip in reverse to try and raise money for this organization that we're supporting called CASA, the Center for Adolescents of San Miguel de Allende. And we're doing this through our registered Canadian charity called Amistad Canada. And in the United States, they have a website, which is, I think, empowercasa.org.
And so you're planning to travel 2,500 miles and hoping to raise $25,000?
That's correct, yes.
And so far, how much do you have?
So we've got about 15,000. So we're a little past the halfway mark, but we have to get up to that $25,000 mark pretty soon.
So. Okay. So do you expect for people to support? And how can they do it if they want to support?
Well, if they want to support it, they can go on this website, empowercasa.org, and they can make a donation. And when it says what the donation is about, they can just mention that this is the Biciclo project, which is to raise money for CASA.
And when do you expect to get to San Luis, San Miguel de Allende?
I should be there October 28th.
October the 28th.
Yeah. And I understand we'll have a bit of a party when I get there.
Lots of margaritas, maybe?
Creo que sí.
Do you speak Spanish?
Poquito.
Okay. Well, very well. Thank you very much.
Okay.
I'm going to see if I can talk to the Mexican Consul that has been... tell me a little bit about the support that Guillermo Ordorica has given you.
Well, it's wonderful because they came out and met me on the highway and we rode in together. And this man is a real cyclist.
Yeah.
You should pay attention to his jersey there because that's a very important jersey.
I know. Let me talk to him.
Yeah.
Can you step, you know, together with him? Because I need... Okay, very well.
Yes, what?
Well, Guillermo, it is unfortunate, you know, that these motorcycles are passing through at the moment. It is very hard, you know, to have this conversation. But tell me about this experience and how, even though you're not in Mexico, you welcome him to Mexico.
Well, yeah, thank you very much. It's an amazing experience to join a person like John Murtaugh, not just because he's a great super athlete, but also because he's a very solidarian person with human causes related with child support and also against violence. So so we really feel very proud of having friends coming from Canada through all the way to the United States pedaling, showing us that their age, he's 70 years old, and it's amazing the fitness he has, and showing us that you can do everything anytime in your life, whenever you want to do it.
As long as you exercise.
As long as you're able to do it, he's able to do this. He's joining us together here in the bridge. We are receiving him as a real hero, and we hope to be good host for him in Mexico, and we will offer him with all kind of supports here in the city of Reynosa. We have made arrangements for him, a nice hotel, nice food, and I'm sure he will need to make some repairs on his bike for free. And they will go tomorrow, I understand, to Monterrey. So we feel very happy about having him here. This is the best proof that Mexico, US, and Canada are good friends, not just the governments, especially the people, the common people as us. We are probably the best capital of the three countries in North America.
Thank you very much. Is there anything else?
You're very welcome. John, thank you.
Yeah, it's a pleasure.
Thank you.
Welcome.